If you've ever been interested in quantum mechanics, then you've probably heard of Schrodinger's thought experiment about the cat. Schrodinger's cat is a thought experiment devised by Erwin Schrodinger to highlight what he saw as an absurdity in the Copenhagen interpretation of quantum mechanics. Here's a gist. Imagine a cat stuck in a sealed box. Inside the box is a vial of poison, a radioactive material with a 50% chance of decaying within an hour. If the material decays, it triggers a mechanism that releases the poison, killing the cat. According to the Copenhagen interpretation, until you open the box and observe the cat, it exists in a state called superposition, like particles. This means that the cat is neither alive nor dead, but a bizarre combination of both possibilities at the same time. Schrodinger's point was that this concept, perfectly valid for tiny particles in quantum mechanics, becomes ridiculous when applied to macroscopic objects like cats. We intuitively know the cat can't be both alive and dead. The experiment has sparked debates about the nature of reality, the role of the observer in quantum mechanics, and when the state of superposition collapses into one definite outcome, alive or dead in this case. Physicists propose that the superposition collapses not necessarily because of a conscious observer, but because any interaction with the environment, like the Geiger counter detecting decay, forces the system into one state. So the thought experiment has become a pop culture phenomenon, highlighting the strange and counterintuitive aspects of quantum mechanics. Here's a solution to the whole dilemma. What is observed is not a cat, but sense perceptions, images, feelings, and thoughts, SIFT, SIFT. Both the cat as sensations, sense perceptions, images, feelings, and thoughts, and the embodied observer or Geiger counter or any classical system is also experienced as sensations, sense perceptions, images, feelings, and thoughts. Sense perceptions are quantum in nature. So the observer is not the embodied observer or the Geiger counter or any extension as an instrument, as a classic instrument. That's not the observer. Neither the embodied observer nor the classical instruments, Geiger counter, etc., which are extensions of the embodied observer's ability to observe. Both that embodied observer and its instruments and the cat are entangled at a very fundamental level as sensations. All sensations, sound, touch, sight, taste, and smell, ultimately are quantum in nature. So the ultimate observer is the non-local observer that observes the so-called cat and the measuring device, the embodied observer and instruments. Both are observed in the non-local domain as entangled phenomena, as entangled quantum phenomena. Okay, because that's all we experience, entangled quantum phenomena. Our sense perceptions are quantum in nature. Our observation is quantum in nature, even though we think we're observing a classical body like a cat or our own body. We're only observing sense perceptions. And of course, they give rise to images in the mind and also feelings and thoughts. And all of these are quantum in nature. So there's no dilemma. both you as the embodied observer and the cat as the embodied observed are actually just like spin up and down at the same time in superposition until measured, and the measurement is always made spontaneously in the non-local domain, whichever theory we buy, Copenhagen, decoherence, multiverses, doesn't matter. This is the solution to Schrodinger's thought experiment. He thought he was the observer and the cat was the observed, but actually both the embodied observer and the embodied observed are entangled as quantum events in the non-local domain. I mean, let me know if this makes sense to you, because ultimately there's only the non-local observer, and that is you and me, and the source of all experience that can only come beyond by going beyond all concepts and perceptions to the source, pure consciousness, immeasurable, infinite, fundamental, irreducible, incomprehensible, imperceivable, not conceptualizable, but real.